Why do we work at something we call our job? We spend so much of our time at our jobs, and though the question might be so far removed from what we think of in our day-to-day lives, it might be worth asking the question, why is it that everyone refers to what they do for a living as a job? Because if you try to quickly find out from Google where the word job comes from, Google tells you it doesn't know. But this is kind of important when you consider how quickly we grow up, not really realizing how precious our free time is. And it's not long before we're shipped off to a cubicle, performing a skill or task day after day, week after week, for most of the rest of our lives. And while this video may not give us the exact reason why you work at the Verizon store or commute to the Flatiron District every morning, it may give us a better understanding of what exactly we're doing. And perhaps from there, you can decide what to expect and what to not expect to get out of your job. Believe it or not, the first source that we turn to for an answer here is the Bible. The oldest story of the Bible is not Genesis, but is a story that scholars generally agree was written sometime between the 7th and 4th centuries BC. Job. The scripture describes a tragic story about a man who worked hard, did everything right, never caused harm to anyone, never even sinned, but who loses everything from his wife and family to his home and wealth, and grapples with the question, why? So what do they call this man? Job. Or Job. Either way, it's spelled the same. And though the pronunciation may throw some off, make no mistake that this biblical passage is very likely a large part of the origin of our modern word job, because in Hebrew, the language from which our most ancient biblical texts are derived, the word Job, or job, has two meanings. One who returns, kind of like what your job keeps you doing each day, or the enemy. And it becomes pretty clear that both of these apply to exactly what you and I would today call a job. Because every day we do go to battle, whether the enemy is the job itself, or that we are the enemy of those who have to supply us with a paycheck, the point is that it is a fight. A fight that keeps us coming back over and over again. And we do it for a salary. And Kevin O'Leary said it best when talking about a salary.
A salary is the drug they give you when they want you to forget about your dreams. Because it's very easy to stay in that world where somebody is mitigating your risk.
Time is all we really have on this earth. And it's only when our time here is threatened that we really start to appreciate the gift that life truly is. So when you're running out of time, is your job really going to be what's on your mind? Because while these jobs keep us afloat and allow us to survive, they rob us of our most valuable resource, and with it, our energy, as they keep us returning to them. But ultimately, what you should take away from this video is that if you're in a job you absolutely hate, get out while you still can. Pursue your dreams. Do something that's meaningful to you. Because it's going to be misery either way. You might as well get something that you love to do, because misery will then evaporate. For other videos and more content, check out my channel Beyond Common Knowledge and click below to subscribe. It costs you nothing but a click, but it means everything to me and other YouTubers out there. And for more access and benefits, including newsletters and request a video, check out my Patreon page.